A Kansas City man admitted he was funneling money from the heartland right into the hands of al-Qaeda terrorists.
Tonight, he's facing a lengthy prison term for what he pleaded guilty to today in federal court. KMBC 9's Dan Weinbaum has the late details for us. Dan?
Well, it may be hard to imagine that the tentacles of the terrorist group al-Qaeda would reach all the way to here, East Truman Road in 435, but they did. Money that was supposed to go into a used auto parts store that's no longer here instead went to fund terrorism overseas. The embassy attacks in Africa, the USS Cole bombing, 9/11, and other attacks planned by al-Qaeda and funded with money like the cash Khalid Wazani was sending overseas.
Wazani admitted that he provided material support to al-Qaeda by personally providing over $23,000.
U.S. Attorney for Missouri's Western District, Beth Phillips, revealed that Wazani admitted he took loans from local Kansas City banks under the guise of expanding his auto parts store on East Truman Road. Instead, he sent money to the United Arab Emirates to buy a condo where it was sold and the profits.
And used the proceeds from that scheme to send overseas in support of al-Qaeda.
He sent money twice, once in the summer of 07 and then in the summer of 08. So who is Khalid Wazani? He's a naturalized citizen, originally from Morocco, 32 years old. He last lived here in South Kansas City, a neighbor to this man who spoke to Michael Mahoney.
It surprised me and it really hurts a standing fellow citizen or neighbor, this type of, I am not speaking what is true and what is not true, but if it true, that actually not acceptable.
In his plea agreement, Wazani admitted he spoke to others about stepping up involvement for al-Qaeda beyond sending money,
including fighting in Afghanistan, Iraq, in Somalia.
But U.S. Attorney Phillips says up until his arrest, he was not a threat.
We have no evidence that Wazani engaged in any specific plot against the United States government.
Though Wazani did admit he swore an oath of allegiance to al-Qaeda. Now, Khalid Wazani was arrested in February. An unnamed co-conspirator was helping him out to pass the money along to al-Qaeda. The U.S. attorney would not go into that part of the investigation. We're live in Kansas City. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you very much, Dan. For bank fraud, money laundering, and aiding terrorists, Khalid Wazani faces up to 65 years in prison.